Hey guys, Denver Riddle here. I'm a colorist and longtime user of DaVinci Resolve, going back to version 8 when it first came out for the Mac. And people always ask me, should they switch to Resolve? Does it have a steep learning curve? And will it work with other applications like Premiere or Final Cut Pro 10? Well, in this DaVinci Resolve review, I'm gonna share with you everything you need to know to make an informed decision. We'll talk about advantages, disadvantages, differences, etc., etc. So let's get right to it. Also, if you want to learn more about our Color Grading Academy, you can sign up for our free 1-hour online workshop. You'll find a link for that in the description below. Now, first and foremost, DaVinci Resolve has a long track record as a high-end color correction system, even being touted as being used on more feature films and episodic television series than any other system in Hollywood. In recent years, DaVinci has gained steam in the semi-professional and professional market because of its ability to be a video editor, color corrector, audio mixer, VFX compositor, making it the top all-in-one post-production platform. For instance, instead of having to go out to After Effects or Motion for VFX, or to Logic Pro or Audition for audio, you can finish everything right there within one application. Now, the caveat to all this is that when first-time users open up DaVinci for the first time, it can seem really daunting. But not to worry, it has a streamlined, easy-to-use workflow, and you don't have to use everything that's actually in there. You can just stick to the things that you really need and know. Now let's talk about price before we jump into and start reviewing the interface. What's unprecedented for an application like this is there's a very capable free version that has nearly all the features that you would ever need. And if you buy a Blackmagic camera, it actually ships with a full studio license worth $300. So obviously, if you want to purchase the studio version Sin camera, a license is $300 and is comparable in price to Final Cut Pro 10. And if you're using Adobe Premiere, that's currently $240 a year for an annual subscription that you must pay for every year, that makes downloading a free copy or buying the studio version a no-brainer. So this is an insane value for a Hollywood level production tool. Now, one thing to keep in mind is that you can actually edit a project inside of Premiere or Final Cut Pro 10 and then export an XML of your project, essentially allowing you to import it into DaVinci for final color grading and finishing. This process is known as round tripping. So if you're not quite ready to abandon Premiere or Final Cut, this is a nice way to get your feet wet. All right, so let's review this thing and make it easier to digest. DaVinci Resolve is divided into 7 pages following a left to right workflow, meaning you start your project on the left, importing your media, and finish your project by exporting it in the deliver page on the right. First, we have the media page where we can browse through our media, preview clips, and import them into the project. We can also just drag and drop clips from our Finder window directly into the media pool. From here, we can organize our clips into bins or folders and add or modify clip metadata. Now, once we have them in the media pool, we can begin editing. We have 2 editorial pages to choose from, the cut page and the edit page. But which one is right for you? Well, they both allow you to edit like you would in any other NLE, but the cut page is specifically designed for making fast-paced cuts, like say for a news broadcast or daily vlogs that you'd upload to YouTube. What's also awesome is that any changes we make in the cut page, we can further refine in the edit page. Now let's take a closer look at the cut page. As you can see, we have access to the media pool, and this is the same as the project window in Premiere or the browser window in Final Cut, where we find all of our media for our project. The monitor window is where we can see our source clips from the media pool, and the timeline in the middle is where we assemble our edit. It has some really nice features like viewing our clips like a film strip, and we have easy access to most of the editing, motion, and titling controls. What I really love about the cut page is the ability to view all the clips as a single clip in the monitor window. Then what I can do is I can quickly scrub through all the clips, setting my in and out points with the keyboard shortcuts I and O, Then by either clicking the smart insert button or the keyboard shortcut F9, we can drop edits into the timeline one after another. As you can see, this will really allow you to fly through your edit. We can even finish here if we wanted to by exporting straight from the cut page, and there are even special social media support for formats like portrait and square. Now let's jump to the edit page. Now this is more of the traditional workspace that you're probably already familiar with in Premiere, as well as legacy versions of Final Cut. Again, here we have access to the media pool, which we can also import clips directly into here. We have a source monitor, a program monitor, and the effects library containing all of our video and audio effects and transitions. We have a traditional inspector, just like you'd find in Premiere and Final Cut, for modifying the position, scale, crop, opacity of clips, and for making changes to any other effects that we add. Keyframing is also supported for animating changes to parameters over time, and you can see the keyframe editor in the timeline is similar to Final Cut's. The interface is customizable, where we can resize and close some of the windows for more real estate. But a drawback you'll find in Resolve is it isn't as flexible as Premiere and Final Cut in terms of customization. For instance, some panels aren't resizable, and we certainly can't reposition the windows any way that we want. This really isn't too much of a deal breaker, but it might be more of an issue on smaller screen laptops. Now let's assume you have a locked edit or finished edit and you need some VFX work or compositing. Well, all you need to do is switch to the Fusion page. Fusion has heavyweight VFX capabilities, being a great alternative to After Effects, Motion, or Nuke. Now, we could talk for days about what can be done in Fusion and how to do it, but the good news is, if you're not particularly keen to handle all the VFX yourself, you can always hand the project off to a VFX artist where they can do the necessary work for you using the same project file within the Fusion page. Isn't that awesome? But just to give you an idea of what is possible inside of Fusion, you can do motion graphics, chroma keying, 3D compositing, vector painting, rotoscoping, generate 3D particles, and so on. Again, you can have someone else do the VFX for you, but if you just need simple titles, you can just handle all that within the edit page. All right, onto the color page, which DaVinci Resolve is originally known for, and it's built a large part of its success on. The color tools you find here are far superior to the color tools in Premiere or Final Cut Pro 10, but they do take some time to learn and get used to. So this is a drawback. Now, if you're not familiar with a nodal editor, it can be either intuitive or intimidating as a new concept. But the gist of it is, you can kind of think of it like a graphical mind map, making it easier to stay organized with your color grades. For instance, in the first node, you can do a simple color correction, and in the second, you can add a look. It can be as simple and straightforward as that. Now, we have our traditional telecine controls, editor for raw cameras, color chart support, RGB curves, hue curves, key qualifier for color masks, shape masks with power windows, 3D motion tracker for tracking shapes, and more. To explore these tools in more depth, you can check out our DaVinci Resolve crash course, and you can just click the thumbnail to open that in a new page. We also have the ability to save our color grades to the gallery so that we can recall them later, get real-time previews of LUTs, and a split screen feature for making shot-to-shot matching as easy and painless as possible. Now, while Resolve does support OpenFX for third-party developers, you won't find the same plethora of third-party support as you'll find with Premiere and Final Cut Pro 10. But it does support plugins like CinemaGrade, which I'm using here, which gives the ability to do on-screen color grading and a unique false color feature for nailing the right exposure. Finally, one of the greatest strengths of Resolve in terms of color is the professional color management that's built in. It also has an ACES color science option that was developed by the Academy. A big challenge you'll find today is dealing with different cameras on the same shoot and how each camera represents colors differently. Well, the good news is Resolve solves this problem by allowing you to choose which camera the media was captured on, what color space you're delivering to, i.e. broadcast or web. These features you don't typically find in other NLEs, and one of the biggest complaints I constantly see are users who export a project from Premiere and then find the exported file doesn't look the same as it did in the project timeline. With Resolve, this is not as much an issue. Now it's time for sweet audio mixing, and for that, we have the Fairlight page. Again, if you're not keen to do it yourself, you can hire it out to somebody else that can do it for you with the same project file, or if you do want to do it yourself, it's a great alternative to Adobe Audition, Logic Pro, or Pro Tools. In the Fairlight page, you'll find the media pool, the effects library supporting VST audio plugins, the index section, which displays the track list, and markers. The sound library browser gives us access to sound effect libraries that we may not already have in the media pool. An ADR panel provides a professional workflow for doing automated dialogue replacement. We also have audio meters, an expanded audio mixer, video viewer, metadata panel, inspector, and audio timeline. Now keep one thing in mind here. If at any point, for any reason, if we need to, we can jump back to the color, fusion, or edit pages, make changes, and then continue on. The magic of all this is because we're in the same application, everything is automatically updated in the different pages. Now, once the project is complete, it's time to deliver. So to export a project, we'll head to the deliver page. From here, we can export the project in a variety of codecs. If you can name it, you can do it. There's the ability to render a DCP package for cinema projection. And like Final Cut and Premiere, it has export presets for commonly used formats for uploading to YouTube and video. So that's pretty much a high-level review of DaVinci Resolve. What do you think? Is it better than Premiere or Final Cut Pro 10? Let me know what you think in the comments. Now, what makes this video possible is our Color Grading Academy for DaVinci Resolve. If you'd like to learn more about that, then sign up for our free 1-hour online workshop where we reveal our top color grading secrets to help you set your films apart. You'll find a link for that in the description below. And if you want to see more videos like this and be notified when our next grading video comes out, just click that subscribe button and then the bell to be notified of our next video. All right, over and out. Enjoy using Resolve.